Thanks for joining us for this New Mexico in Focus Web Extra. We are speaking with Kathleen Sabo, the Executive Director of New Mexico Ethics Watch. Thanks for sticking around.
Yeah, absolutely.
One of the things that we didn't have time to get to on the program this week was where we are with the Ethics Commission. That's something that you've worked quite hard on, as one might imagine from your name. The Ethics Commission was able to accept complaints as of January 1st of this year. What do you make of the composition of the commission and of its powers so far?
Well, you know, much still has to be seen. Obviously, there's been nothing public revealed about any complaints filed or anything since they opened business on January 1st. By all accounts, the people who were chosen as commissioners are fabulous people who are very interested in ethics. And the executive director is someone who began working on issues out of the DFA from the get-go.
Okay.
So it looks like a strong group up there. The issue we're having is with funding. Surprisingly, you know, when it first came into being, there was a thought we need like at least $1 million a year. And the legislature said, we're going to give you $500,000. Come back and ask for more, okay, when you need it. So the commission has come back and said, we need supplemental money. And then this is what we need for the next year. And the legislature has come back with amounts below what they've requested. Now, the executive didn't.
Okay.
But the legislature did. And we have strong feelings about that. We've got to get things going in the right direction, you know, and so to hamper their ability to hire the right amount of people and to undertake the tasks that they are designed to undertake, it doesn't seem right, particularly in this state where we have this abundance of funds right now.
Yes. One of the things that we've seen in administrations of various colors is that whether it's Medicaid fraud, whether it's charter school finances, whether it's regulation for the oil and gas industry, if you don't hire the people to do the work, it's not going to get done. That's a way to sort of strangle it. Do you have a sense that that's what's happening here?
It's hard to know. Again, people aren't going to come out and tell you. I don't know. I think there's always been a strong resistance to an ethics commission. There were legislators who took it on, whether it was Damon Eli or Greg Nybert or Peter Wirth, and just said, we're going to get this done. The public wants it. We're going to do it. We had 75% who voted on this constitutional amendment. But there's always been resistance, and there was strong resistance for many years in the Senate. So I'm sure that resistance is there. Maybe it's just like, hey, we don't want to give you the money until we see what you can do. But to me, it's like, give me the money, see what we can do, and then we can make adjustments if need be.
Sure, of course. These are people who know that you can do far less with less money.
Yeah.
And so there is the potential that they're like, okay, now you have your ethics commission in name only, but you're not going
to
get much.
And we would hate to see that. I mean, you know, that's happened in places across the country where...
Really?
Yeah, like Wisconsin, they just sort of dropped the funding considerably, and that commission suffered mightily. And you would have to say then the public suffered. You know, because things were going on that they couldn't know about. And, you know, people have asked me, I just want to say this, people have asked me, do you think having the Ethics Commission is going to change things? One can only hope that even by just being in existence, people understand that they ought to do the right thing. So let's make it strong to have it be as powerful as it possibly can be. And I don't mean powerful, you know, taking on things they ought not to take on or, you know, harming people, but just helping people do the right thing. And see, that's one of the things they really want to do is educate. And so that's some of the funding that won't be there, you know, to help educate and to keep things from getting to the point where complaints are filed.
Sure. So as it works through the process, we've got the governor's budget, we've got the lawmaker's budget. The sense is, you know, you'd think that it would end up somewhere in between, but that's not always how it happens.
No, it isn't. And one could argue that in between isn't even good enough. And, you know, I'm going to leave it to the people on the Ethics Commission staff to really argue their case in terms of the exact amount they need. But they do need to staff up, and they do need to undertake these efforts, and they do need the funding to do it.
Well, thanks for keeping an eye on it for us.
Yeah, absolutely, Matt. New Mexico Ethics Watch and lots of other good government groups taking that on.
We'll follow it. Thank you.
All right. Thank you, Matt.
You bet.